here at the end, please, for your questions. We have to move on for Dr. Hans Pilegaard, please. Now we change for chest wall deformities. Thank you for the speakers. We have to, he will talk with us about what we know about cardiac and pulmonary function after the correction of pectus excavatum. Please introduce yourself, please.
Thank you. Thank you for the invitation. I'm thoracic surgeon from Denmark. I have done more than 2,000 cases of pectus excavatum with the NOS procedure. So I will talk about what we know about cardiac and pulmonary function after the correction of pectus excavatum. Disclosure, I'm a consultant at Zimmer Biomet. When we meet these patients in the outpatient clinic, we will often see a boy with a bad posture. And we have for many years been told that this is only a cosmetic complaint, that might be because the patient is complaining about cosmetic. But when we start to ask about the history of the patient, more than half of them will have symptoms like exercise intolerance, lack of endurance, shortness of breath. And we can say, is that a new thing? I don't think so, because already from the beginning of the era of the surgical treatment, there was concerns about the cardiac function in these patients. You can see here with different inputs. And is it only a problem for the young patient? I'm not sure, because we will be back in that. When we ask patients after the surgery, they will say they are doing much, much better physically. And you can see here, there's a paper from Holland with a look at the patients more than 50 years, and they had totally 46 patients. And of these patients, 9 patients first had the symptoms after the fourth decade. And looking, studying these patients, they couldn't find other reasons that the pectus in 12 patients. And of these, 11 patients was corrected and symptoms was reduced substantially or disappeared completely. It should go. Why it's not working? Sorry, it's coming now. So what is happening when we use a NOS procedure? When we elevate the sternum, we got more space for the heart and for the lungs. There's a lot of studies about the quality of life, and when we study quality of life, we also ask the patients about their physical performance, and we can see that both the patients and the parents, if it is a child, tell us that there is a significant increase in their physical performance. This is a study from Norfolk, US, and we have also done a similar study in Denmark with more than 100 patients, and we can see that, again, both the patients and the parents tell us that there is a significant increase in their physical performance. And we have two things. We have the lungs, we have the cardiac performance. If you look at the lungs, if you look at the chest wall, we can see that before surgery, if we compare a patient with pectus excavatum with a patient without, there is a difference in the respiratory pattern, because the pectus patient will use the abdominal part much more than the patient without pectus. And when we then study the patient after surgery, we will see that the abdominal part of respiration has decreased more than 500%, and you have increased the movement of the chest. So what does that mean for the lung function? I will say that in most studies, it only shows that the FEV1 is significantly increased. This is from US, this figure here. We can see other parts of the lung function here, and we can see before surgery, more is below the 80%, which is lower normal border, and they are raised after surgery. We have also done a study in Denmark where we looked at 48 patients with pectus, and we had a control group of 25 because these patients was between 14 to 17 years and they are growing, so we have to take into account that there might be a change because they are growing. And we could see before surgery, the FEV1 was significantly lower than the controls, but after we have removed the bars after 3 years, they were equal. So there is a significant increase in the FEV1. And what about the heart? Here is a very beautiful visualization, what the sternum does to the heart. You can see to the left, but before surgery, there is an impression in the right ventricle. And after the sternum has been elevated, you can see there's a more straight wall of the ventricle. And it's only done with the vacuum belt, you can see on the right side. So when you do the surgical procedure, you will even get a much better correction. So you will get a more relief of the pressure on the heart. So why is some of the patients don't have any symptoms and other patients have symptoms? I think that might be the position of the heart, because in some patients, as you see on the right side, the heart is totally pressed to the left, so there's no compression of the right ventricle. But if it's more in the middle, you will have a compression and you will have more symptoms. So what are we doing when we are using the NOS procedure, when we are elevating the sternum? You can see here, it's a study just published at the EPOP, where they have started patients before surgery and 3 months after. You can see they have elevated the sternum about 4 centimeters. The circumference of the chest is in mean, also 4 centimeters higher. And they have tested the patient with a 6 minutes walk test, and they significantly increased with around 100 meters in distance. So it really means something to the patients. There are several studies which have looked at the cardiac function in these patients. Some are quite good, some are not so good, because when you study young patients, you have to take into account that they are growing, and if you don't have a control group, you are not sure what your results are showing. But here is one where they have tested the patient before surgery, where they have 12 patients and 20 controls. And it was a bicycle test, and they could show that they had a lower cardiac index, and also the oxygen pulse was significantly lower than predicted. Here is a study from France, which they used the open procedure, and they followed the patient pre-op 6 months after surgery and 12 months later, and found that there was a significant increase in the VO2 max and also in the oxygen pulse. Here, another study, also a follow-up study with a pre-op study, and after bar removal, 67 patients, teenagers, and they could show that the oxygen pulse was significantly increased, but there was no change in the cardiac parameters. Maybe because that they did the study of the cardiac parameters in rest, because there are normally no change before and after surgery. It's only when you exercise the patients. And I think we have, as the first group in the world, shown that patients after surgery really increase their cardiac performance. We've followed here 47 patients and had this control group of 26, and we could see that pre-op, the patient was performing about 20% lower than the controls. And after 3 years, when we have removed the bars, they were equal. So we have raised them with about 25%, and I think that's really a significant raise in cardiac performance for the patients. And what kind of patient was that? You can see the HALA index before surgery is 4.9. and the Crohn's ones had a normal HALA index, and post-op there was no difference between the two groups. We tried to show the same in adults, patients more than 21 years, but we only have 12 patients. I think there was a trend that we were doing better, but we didn't have a significant result. Other groups have shown that the decreased performance on the heart is caused by a decreased cardiac output because the decreased stroke volume, as you see here in the paper from Tardy from 2015. Concerning echocardiography, chambers and right ventricle has been shown to be significantly increased in several studies, so there is really a big change of the configuration of the heart when you elevate the sternum. Here is another echocardiography study, and you should just look at the left side where you can see the right atrium before surgery and after surgery. There is a significant increase. That's the two columns to the left. And to the right, you will see that's before bar removal, and after bar removal, there's no difference. So there's a sustained change after surgery. And the same has been shown with the MRI, also that the EF of the ejection fraction of the heart is significantly increased. There's one paper with best evidence of this topic, and it's been published in the European Journal for some years ago, and the conclusion was that the pulmonary function is an early decrease post-op, but a significant improvement late, and the cardiac function, there is an early improvement, and which is sustained in follow-up. Thank you for your attention.